like, I'll have somebody turn in, like, a job rejection letter, and it'll be like, "Dear Patricia, we're sorry to inform you that you've not been hired to work at Olive Garden this summer." And I'm like, okay, that's a job rejection letter. But it has nothing to do with the story that I put forth. Like, I don't understand how it happens, but it does. I think what it is people read the chapter's content, and they read it in silence, they never actually read the handout. So they think there's any version of that type of silence. Chapter 9 has specific tips for job rejection letters in it, so be sure to look through those. We'll talk about all types of negative use messages, but you're only doing this one type for the assignment. And you've got the points breakdown, just like usual. Lather, rinse, repeat, just like the last assignment, okay? So negative use messages. So when you got to tell somebody something that they don't want to hear, so this kind of, you know, segues right back to when we were talking about routine and positive messages. What about when the customer is at fault and you cannot make restitution or it's not wanting to make it right? You should tell them no, sorry. These are good tips for whenever stuff has gone south. How to handle people that are going to be angry, because usually you're going to be telling them some version of no. So there are five basic goals to reach in every negative use instance, no matter what that bad news is. And as you walk through these, you can probably have PTSD memories of when bad stuff has happened to you, or you got stuck in some of these goals. First goal, you actually have to deliver the bad news. That sounds so silly, but sometimes there are cases where, say, like, you're a manager and you have a colleague who works underneath you and you have to let them go, and you might hedge around doing that too long because you don't want to do it. It's almost always better just to be plain Jane and state what's going on. Second goal, get the audience to accept the bad news. Probably seen this happen before. You tell somebody something bad has happened, they're told to not, like, they're being evicted, but they won't leave the house, or someone's passed away and they refuse to accept it for a while. Lots of different circumstances that can occur. When a person goes into shock, they tend to be in denial. So, how do we make sure not be a jerk? So even if you think that someone's done something stupid or you think they deserve what they get, you don't make any comment that would infer that you're thinking that, because it's really not part of the equation. You're just a deliverer of information. I'll be honest with you, there are times where people have failed my classes. I'm glad they failed. But I would never tell a student that.
You sure about that? Was that the choice that you made?
From your job. A person who's been rude day in and day out, or constantly, like, walks in late, or whines and moans about everything that comes their way, even though everybody else is having to do it too, and they're fine. You know, sometimes you're happy to see someone get what you think they deserve. And it's not that I failed them, they failed themselves. Part of the reason you want to maintain your goodwill is the next goal, which is you want to maintain your organization's good image. You don't want to make the company or business you represent look bad because you treat someone poorly. Then the last one, one that people tend to have the most trouble with in practice, is you want to craft messages in such a way that it limits any future discussion on the subject matter. You may have done this before if you've been around the track of the school for a while. Maybe you didn't get a good grade on the assignment, so you start pounding your professor or your teacher about why you didn't get a good grade. Gives you an explanation, but something about an explanation doesn't seem efficient or make sense, so you contact them again. Then you get into a whole back and forth, and now you're just mad at each other because you're antagonizing each other, and it goes on and on and on. So what do you do to make sure that people don't keep talking about something? Well, one is you do the first four goals. You don't skip out on one of those. You don't give them a reason to bring it up again because you act. But you also need to be very clear and concrete that the matter is resolved and settled in this spot. Another strategy you can use for that is if it is something.